Hello to my 3 subscribers. Thank you for being so dedicated and watching my channel, even though it is not a YouTube channel. Today I have a special surprise. I am going crawdad fishing. If you don't know what a crawdad is, that's probably because you are a heathen who calls it either a crawfish or a crayfish. But here in Indiana, it is called a crawdad, and so we're going to call it a
crawdad.
Alright, so you may be asking me, Darby, how do you hunt a crawdad? And I'm going to tell you, I have no clue because like I started to read an article online and then I got bored. Let's get started.
So we are going to crawdad hunt in the woods across the street from my house. There is a creek, and I am told that crawdads live in creeks. Now, I've never actually seen a crawdad in this creek, but I've never actually looked for a crawdad in this creek. To tell the truth, I have never even looked for crawdads. Crawdads have always just come to me in the form of mini lobsters. Fun fact about crawdads, they are as old as crustaceans, which means they've been here before us, and if we are not careful, they will be here after us, which is why I'm going to go hunt them today.
I said that really loudly, and there's a nature preserver truck right next to me, so if I get evicted from my own lands, you know why.
We're going on a trip in our favorite rocket ship, looking for crawdads, carbohydrates.
And I'm truly regretting all my life decisions that led me to this point. The key to hunting crawdads is to not be noticed, because the second crawdads know you're there, that's the second when they leave. So I'm going to go ahead and get in my crawdad hunting ensemble. I'll be right back. So as you can see, I am decked out in my crawdad ensemble, and I am now virtually indistinguishable from your everyday plant. I have my crawdad hunting sunflower hat, which will make sure that when I hunker down, the crawdads can't see me. Here are my tools. I have my crawdad bashing bat. Now this is only if the crawdads get violent, because I do not condone violence against crawdads. I also have my crawdad picker upper. This is what I'll use to scoop the crawdads up. I also have my binoculars, so that way I can sit a distance away from the crawdads and examine them until I have a chance to snipe. All right guys, it's crawdad hunting time. So this takes a lot of patience, so we may not see anything for a long time. So it's been a while and we haven't seen any crawdads, so I thought I would liven things up by just kind of telling you guys what I bring on my crawdad hunting trip, so you guys can replicate this at your own house. I have my pocket constitution, America, just in case someone decides to take away my rights while I'm out here hunting crawdads. I also have my French pocket phrase guidebook, because I feel like crawdads were probably originally from France, just because it sounds like a really French thing, you know, crawdads. So just in case they don't speak English, I want to be really considerate and let them know they're welcome in our country. Now, I have taken French for 4 years, but that's not indicative of whether or not I speak it. I don't speak French. So, luckily, I can now communicate to the crawdads.
Qu'est-ce que vous avez comme légumes? J'ai une réservation. Vous êtes marié? Puis-je vous offrir une cigarette?
I also have a field guide to wildlife. Unfortunately, it is a field guide to African wildlife. I can identify the difference between a golden-breasted bunting and a kangaroo. It's been a while, but luckily I brought some snacks. Wow, I feel better already. Trader Joe's mints, everybody.
Comment down below if you believe in predestination.
Every good scientist knows that they have to record their observations. So luckily, I have my field notebook everywhere I go. Noon, no crawdads. Forecast? No crawdads. Bad news, guys. I'm gonna actually have to head back. Aww. I really wish I could stay out here longer with you, though. I feel like we can all learn something from this experience. Like, even if we didn't see any crawdads, like, we still persevered and we, like, still had fun. And I feel like Me and my 3 subscribers really made a connection today.
Oh my god, is that a spider?
I just saw like 8 legs crawling right by my jacket. Okay, that's it. This was not worth it. This was... From now on, Darbohydrates is an exclusively indoor production. There's a guy coming up behind me, and I'm trying to pass this off as a school project, and not that I'm just crawling in the woods by myself. So I'm gonna walk really quickly and talk about school. I deserve an A for this project because I went out into the woods for a long time, and I collected data on the pH of the water. Guys, he's walking fast too. It's 2 fast walkers racing each other. I am so sorry that you watched this video. I hope you clicked away by now. We didn't see a single crawdad. I think the government is hiding them from me because they know I'd be too efficient and wiping them out. Anyways. That's it from the Buzz Aldrin of YouTube. Cash you later, haters.